three female sailors that have inspired me is tough because there are so many. I think Ellen MacArthur, for me, pioneered that vision that you don't have to be big and strong. You can be small and slight and just clever at your sailing to absolutely dominate the sport and achieve great things. Now I look at the current people that are racing and I see Sam Davies starting the Transat Jacques Vabre, and having sailed with her and against her, she's a true, really good icon of the sport and somebody I look up to. And then it's really hard because there are lots of other people that influence me in different ways, but I think outside of the sport a little bit more. And Denise Lewis, who is a heptathlete, achieved great things in the world of athletics. Multi-disciplines just shows that you have to train on so many levels to accomplish so much. Clean Seas as an initiative was from the UN, and Turn the Tide on Plastic was a promotion of that initiative going around the world in the ocean race. And the momentum we created from that was huge. Lots of people signed the Clean Seas pledge. We are far from solving the issue, but the awareness is right up there now and the conversations are happening. Sailing is a multi-discipline sport. You have to be agile, you have to have endurance, you have to have strength. So you need to address all those things in your training and fitness and preparation. And it's quite often overlooked because time on the water is just as important. But I spend a lot of time having strength programs, endurance programs, and then doing stuff that I really enjoy as well. It's good to be physically fit, but also you need to be mentally fit as well. Sailing as a sport is for everybody, not just the young and not just the rich. And you can actually just go out on the water for fun and enjoyment, and that's what we often forget. And the really good thing is actually visually impaired are just as able to sail, if not better sometimes. I've actually crossed the Atlantic with a visually impaired person and they were the best helm, because there are mechanisms out there. There are speaking compasses, there are the sensations of the wind on your face, and your other senses are heightened if you don't have sight. So do not think that being visually impaired or slightly older is a drawback. There's definitely a way for you to sail. For me, the next year, 2020, is another exciting year, I hope. I've got my fingers crossed for lots of sailing. And also I enjoy doing the other work, so promoting the World Sailing Trust for the health of our planet and our oceans, generating opportunities for young women in sport and promoting the sport, and just helping everybody be a little bit more aware of sustainability as a whole. So the World Sailing Trust looks at three pillars: marine health, youth pathways, and access. And we're here to support M&As and countries and anybody trying to generate more participation. So stay tuned, look at the website and see what's happening. And do please ask us for help. Put it this way, the next ocean race leaves in 2021 and I definitely don't want it to leave without me on the start line. So my fingers are crossed that I'll find a way to be part of that race. The notorious Cape Horn is a tough place. People set off to round it and not everybody succeeds it. I'm very lucky that I've managed 6 times around the world and therefore 6 roundings of Cape Horn in both directions. The intense winds, the big waves that all happen at the same place where you've got very little room to maneuver. So it is notorious for a reason and we're very proud every time we round it as sailors. The World Sailing Trust is after support from everybody. We want to be promoted, we want people to know about us and the work we do, and then ultimately we need to secure funding to enable projects to happen. So if you can tell more people about the World Sailing Trust and the work we do, that's great. If you can make us your charity and support us in a way, then that's great. And if you're a donor that wants to invest in the world of sailing and you think the Trust has a pillar to help that in marine health, youth pathways or access, then please get in touch.